السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This presentation is for chapter 2. و chapter 2 is talking about how can information technology maintain competitive advantage. ازاي استعمال التكنولوجي الانفورميشن تكنولوجي ده يستمر يجعل الشركات عندها تكسب المنافسة بتاعتها في الماركت. Four of the things that helped organizations sustain competitive advantage in the market are supply chain management, customer relationship management, enterprise resource planning, and social media. أربع أشياء من التكنولوجي ساعدت الـ organizations إن هي تكسب المنافسة أو تتبقي يعني مركزها في الماركت محفوظ. أربع أشياء. واحدة هي البرنامج اللي بيستعملوه علشان للتواصل مع الموردين اللي هي supply chain management. افتكر كلمة supply جاية من supply أو supplier اللي هو المورد. ده supply chain management ده برنامج علشان أتواصل مع الموردين بحيث إن المورد يعرف أنا عندي قد إيه من المخزون، وأول ما المخزون ينزل هو يجيب لي الاحتياطي اللي أنا محتاجه. So supply chain management help organizations maintain the least amount of inventory needed. يعني أقل كمية من الانفنتوري محتاجها هما متأكدين إن هي موجودة في الستوك عندك. Supply Chain Management. افتكر ان دي البرنامج بيساعد على التواصل مع الموردين وان يجعل المورد هو اللي بيتحكم في المخزون بتاعه. They track the inventory and send or stock storage only when you need it. So you don't have to maintain a large stock. مش محتاج بقى مخزون كبير. لا محتاج المخزون اللي الكاستمر needed at a certain time. فالسيستم اسمه supply chain management system. هي دي الانفورميشن تكنولوجي that help you أو support the supply chain. supply chain بيعمل ايه؟ بي make sure that you have the necessary inventory for you to sell to the customer. يعني بيضمن ان انت عندك المخزون اللي انت محتاجه علشان تورد للعميل. لما انا ما بخزنش مخزون كبير، بخزن المخزون اللي انا محتاجه بس، بنقول ده just in time. When you are only keeping enough inventory in order for you to deliver products to the service. So just in time, a method for delivering a product or service just in time the customer wants. You don't have to keep large inventory. مش محتاج بقى ابقى عندي مخزون كبير. ليه؟ لأن الـ supply chain will only bring the inventory that I need at a certain time. The supply chain is used في الـ grocery store. They don't have storage. Supplier comes and stock the shelves, and as soon as the stock goes down, supplier knows right away. فالمورد بيبقى عارف هو بيحط على الشلف اللي انت الكاستمر بتاعك العميل بتاعك محتاج. مش محتاج انت مخزون كبير، هو اللي بيمانج ذا انفنتوري. So the supplier manages the inventory. One of the companies that is very famous in effectively managing inventory is that. ده المعروفة ان هي عندها مخزون استراتيجي، يعني they don't carry a lot of inventory. ما بقاش عندهم مخزون كبير ابدا. شوف بص على الجراف. Only that amount of inventory is very low inventory that they keep. المورد العادي او المانيفاكتشرر العادي اللي بيمانيفاكتشر كمبيوتر they carry that high of an inventory. شايف قد ايه مخزون بيخزنوه. وبعدين يبتدي طول الوقت ما هو محطوط المخزون ده عنده ويبتدي يقل المخزون. انما عند دال they don't do the same. شوف هنا عندك ايه، بيقول لك باي هولد اند سيل، تشتري الموارد الخام بتاعتك وتكيب ذم، تخليها عندك، وبعدين بعد ما تجمعها بتبتدي تسل. ده اللي ما بيعملش كده، ده اللي بتسل and source and then they ship. فبيعملوا ايه؟ ده اللي بتبيع الاول من غير ما يكون عندها مخزون، وبعدين حتى في اوقات they send shipment from outside third party، يعني خارج الشركة. يبقى someone in China can ship the monitor and someone can ship the hardware أو the microprocessor and then someone can ship the keyboard and they all go to FedEx and FedEx would package them and it appears as if they have been shipped from them. فأقول تاني ده ما بتبقاش عندها مخزون، هي بتبيع لك الأول من خلال الويب and then they assemble components from different suppliers، يعني بيجيبوا من موردين مختلفين قطع مختلفة، وحتى مش هم اللي بيجمعوها، ساعات FedEx the shipping company، شركة شحن، هي اللي بتجمع الحاجات كلها مع بعض وتبعتها للعميل. So it appears as if it is Dell، يعني بيبان لك ان هي Dell بس هي مش Dell، مش Dell اللي بعت الحاجة، FedEx جمعت كل الحاجة، هي شركة الشحن بيجي لها كل الطلبيات وتجمعها وبعدين ترسلها للعميل، فده بيخلي ده اللي عندها inventory إليه. So as I said in the female class I said that Dell does not keep any inventory. They sell through their web and then they send the order, back order to suppliers. Suppliers bring everything, send everything to FedEx. FedEx will assemble the thing and will ship it as one thing, one product to the customer. So this is really very efficient. So what are the opportunities inside of the supply chain for the organization? ايه الفرص اللي موجودة للشركة من خلال managing the supply chain? The first thing, you can reduce cost. ممكن انا اقلل السعر. How? لأن managing the inventory, keeping a large inventory is costly. لو انت خليت مخزون كبير ده حاجة هتدفعك يعني هيبقى فيه expenses. ليه؟ لأن في المخزن ده، المكان ده ليه إيجار، ليه ثمن، عندك employees، الناس اللي بيشتغلوا علشان خاطر to maintain the storage, there is a cost associated with it. There is technology, the cost of monitoring the inventory, making sure that nothing gets out except through an order. So there is a lot of cost associated with the supply chain. Also, if you maintain a low inventory, طب لو قعدنا معانا مخزون قليل قوي, is this in the best interest of the organization? هل ده في صالح الشركة؟ لا. Why? Because you may forgo بقى sales. You may get customers who need the product and they can't find the product. The product is not on the shelf. يجي لك عميل عايز يشتري وما فيش, وانت you ran out of stock. ما عندكش كافي. So managing the supply chain and getting the products just in time will save you money, will reduce the cost. So using the supply chain enable you to squeeze every penny possible out of the supply chain. ممكن انت تقلل القص, squeeze يعني يعصر, تطلع من every single penny. You're trying to save every single penny. طيب, what else? So you're running the organization, you're running it to grow, transform the organization. So running, run, grow and transform, that is the framework that we talked about in chapter 1. What was that framework saying back? The framework of the run, grow and transform, the RGT, stands for a, يا إما either I'm going to use information technology in order to run daily business processes, so I'm just cutting cost. زي ال overall cost leadership اللي قلناها قبل كده هو. يبقى أنا I'm using the technology, بستعمل التكنولوجي علشان to support، عشان أدعم ال daily business processes اللي هي العمليات اليومية بتاعتي. بستعمل التكنولوجيا عشان أرى زي ال ERP system اللي احنا استخدمناها في اللاب. The ERP system is supporting daily business processes. زي ايه؟ عمليات ايه؟ شراء، عمليات بيع، ال HR، ال financials، everything that you do on a daily basis. كل حاجة اللي بتعملها يوميا ده running. The IT can support daily business processes. يبقى الانفورميشن تكنولوجي دي هتدعم العمليات اليومية بتاعت البيزنس. طيب و how about grow؟ grow means to increase your market share. To increase your market share. So how can I grow? You can grow by differentiation. To differentiate yourself. So differentiation is تمييز. To bring something new into the market. زي مثلا Apple. Apple every now and then they bring something totally different from everyone else. In terms of the phones or the TV or the iWatch. They are innovators. They try to distinguish themselves. They grow and distinguish themselves through differentiation. So, and then there is transformation, total transformation, which is total change and total innovation, something totally new, which is another way of differentiating yourself in the market. So you may ask, what is the difference between growing and transforming? Remember, grow, you focus and you try to differentiate, but it is the same type of products, electronics method. Transformation is either you go into new markets that you haven't entered, يعني تخش بقى في أسواق جديدة أنت ما دخلتهاش قبل كده, or you bring in totally new products that you have not produced before. The goal, as we said, in terms of leadership, is to squeeze out every penny. You want to reduce the cost. So, in order to reduce the cost, you try to remove any redundancy. بتشيل أي حاجة متكررة inside of the supply chain. You try to maintain a very low stock. ما يبقاش عندك مخزون كبير, مخزون قليل, just in time. So you put on the shelf whatever the customer will need at a certain time. هتحط على الشلفز دي على الأرفف whatever the customer need at a certain.
So the use of the SEM will help you in order to make sure that you have the right items on time. The fulfillment. Fulfillment means getting the right raw material, for example, the right items that you need for production on time. Logistics is for internal operations, like for example shipping. You want to make sure that you have the lowest cost of shipping. إن سعر ال shipping أقل سعر. Production, you want to make sure that the production lines are running smoothly. They are not stopped because you don't have the raw material. Whatever parts you need, they are available when needed. احنا اتكلمنا قبل كده على ال stock. You don't want to keep a large stock, but then you don't want also to stop production. مش عايز توقف الانتاج عشان ما عندكش الرو ماتيريال. So everything with SCM, with the supply chain management, you will make sure that you have the parts when you need them. You will make sure that the cost of shipping is low. You will make sure that production is not disrupted or interrupted. مش هتبقى تتقطع production because you are waiting for the raw material. You want to make sure that you do not lose sales, the revenue. لأن again, if a customer needs a product and you don't have it on the shelf, then the customer will go somewhere else. So you are foregoing the revenue. بتضيع revenue كده. بتضيع الربح بتاعك لو جه عميل عايز item وهو وانت مش عندك الايتم ده. And you are also foregoing the profit. The cost and price, you want to make sure that the cost and price is at the lowest level. ازاي with the SCM? Because you do not keep, for example, large inventory. You only have things when you need them. So that's the benefit of SCM. So think about it. If you buy items from suppliers for less, and you only keep stock for less, so you are able to give a better price to customers. لو هتشتري القطع الغيار دي أو المواد الخام على سعر واط يعني سعر قليل هتقدر إن أنت تبيع كمان للمستهلك بسعر أقل. وده هيزود المبيعات بتاعتك will grow the sales and then will make you operate for less. يعني هيبقى ال production بتاعتك برضو ال cost بتاعها قليل. It's like a cycle. The cycle doesn't end. You start with buying less material or buying less material or keeping less stock, buying with better prices, because supply chain also allow you, like things like auctions, for example, allow you to buy from the lowest supply. And then because of the low cost, you are able to give a low price. تقدر ان انت تدي سعر منخفض. لو انت بتشتري بسعر منخفض هتقلل السعر. ده هيخلي المبيعات بتاعتك هتزيد. Sales will grow. And as a result, you are able to operate for less. The cost of production, cost of operation, daily operation is for less. So you go one more cycle and so on.
The SCM that we talked about, the IT that support SCM, the technology اللي هي بتدعم ال SCM, originally was created by specialized companies. يعني كان في شركات متخصصة بتعمل ال SCM. بعد كده software companies like SAP, Oracle, Microsoft, they all introduced SCM by a part of the ERP system. So it now becomes part of the ERP system. SAP اللي احنا استعملناه في الكلاس has an SCM module. Oracle e-business suite, they have an SCM module. Microsoft has one. So every single ERP developer have actually included SCM into it. Now we also have other things that support SCM. So the SCM knowledge base is a community for professionals, مكان on the web that allow على الانترنت يعني that allow the professionals to exchange information. So if someone has a problem, لو أي حد عنده مشكلة في in the logistics, in procurement, fulfillment, they can post a message on the supply chain knowledge base and other people will respond to them. يعني بيحطوا بيطرشوا زي ما انتوا بتقولوا رسالة وهم وبقية المجموعة بيردوا عليهم على المشكلة دي. في magazines they deal with supply chain. So supply chain management review, they publish papers about supply chain. The I2 technology, قلت لكم في الكلاس هيبقى في فيديو. So I want you, عايزاكوا click on the link in order to see. And they tell you how with the I2 technologies, with the I2 software, you can actually save a lot of money in terms of avoiding waste. يعني بدل ما يبوظ الأشياء خصوصا في مجال الجروسريز والأكل ما تقدرش ان انت تأخر عملية الشحن وكل ده لان ده بيأثر على الانتاج بتاع المنتج بتاعك. ف throughout the video they tell you how they can save in terms of cost and avoid waste. CIO magazine is a practitioner magazine. يعني ما هيش research oriented, but it talks also about supply chain.